Oh, this one just says, the trepidation of the Dave Matthews fan. It's hilarious to me that people respond to just that. Because you know who you are. It's not easy for them. It's not easy. They can't be out with that. You know what I mean? You can't just put that into the world. You don't know how that's going to be received. Not good, generally. You know, the only place that Dave Matthews fan can truly be comfortable is when they're wearing sandals and cargo shorts jigging around in an arena with other like-minded people. I hope these mushrooms aren't bunk again. Look, I don't need to shit on Dave Matthews. I don't need to take time to do that. I personally don't like him. But this came from a true, honest, beautiful human moment. I'll share that with you. But I do need to address the Dave Matthews thing. Like, look, I listen to a lot of music. I'm very open-minded. I can listen to Parliament in the morning, Burt Jansch in the afternoon, maybe some Graham Parsons, whatever. I mix it up. I'm not just dropping names to be hip. I have an open mind when it comes to music, but I cannot get through two of his songs. I can't get through, like, and I try. By midway through the second song, I get a type of boredom that's not even normal boredom. It's like, there's an edge to it. It's like an aggravated boredom. Like, the boredom sets in, and then I'm like, God, fuck, what the fuck, why? Why? Like, I don't know what that is. But I know people like them, and you know, and good for you. And I know it's hard for you guys. It's very hard to defend that. And the moment that I had, which was kind of beautiful, was it was great. I was in Iowa City, doing a gig. Oh yeah, it's a very interesting town. Like, I've never seen a town more separated into, like, you know, full-on sports meatheads, and then the writers' program. You know, so like. There's just people that are just like, we're gonna win! And then people like, oh, I'm still sad about David Foster Wallace. I'm never gonna get up. You know, like, and somehow there's a perfect yin-yang to the thing. This complete. Okay, so I'm getting coffee in Iowa City. There's a guy getting coffee in front of me. He's ordering, there's a barista there. And the guy ordering coffee says to the guy making coffee, what are you doing this weekend? The guy making coffee looks up and he's like, oh, I'm going to a concert. And then naturally the guy ordering coffee goes, oh, really? Who are you going to see? And then the other guy stood up and I saw it in his face. Dave Matthews Band. And I felt for him. It was courageous. He put himself out there. That's hard. You know, you don't know how it's going to land. It hung there for like two, like really tense seconds. And then the other guy goes, oh, I fucking love Dave Matthews. And I was so happy for them that they had this moment. I knew in my heart they were both wrong. I knew that. But I was happy for them. Because I'm a big-hearted, tolerant person.